keep you humble, humble. All that money start coming in lakes. I draw the Rari through the tunnel, tunnel. I need a passport, I'm riding foreign place. I ain't never had no money.
We are down on the bayou as you get a look inside the Caesars Superdome here in New Orleans.
This is what it looked like just a moment ago in the heart of New Orleans. Folks, there's no place for this noise to go in the Superdome. It is loud, and these fans are ready for football as their Saints get ready to do battle with the Dallas Cowboys. Season already in the rearview mirror, and off we go in week 5 on EA Sports. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Get 9 here on first down as he gets this one up to the 34-yard line. Well, this defense for the Cowboys, they were very strong in the win last week over the Giants.
And I think our statistician, we ended up having to bring the blue tent and put it around him for a while because he was developing a hand injury from having to write down all the turnovers this team forced. 5, 6, 7, 8. Absolutely unbelievable. I hope he'll recover.
And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
So here's a first and 10 at the 38. Off play action, Fields. Flushed out right. That's into a crowd and intercepted. Picked off near the 44. And a return across midfield and to the 46-yard line. Well, not a good omen there. His first throw of the afternoon, intercepted.
And I know what the fans are thinking right now. I hope there's not negative thoughts in his head going forward since that's his first throw of the game. But one of the things I remember about him coming out of school is he's able to wipe things away pretty easily and move on.
Throwing is Stevens. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. That catch good for only a couple.
All defenses worry that whenever anyone catches the ball and has a head of steam come out of the backfield, it could turn into a big play with missed tackles or he runs through people. But they were right there waiting, and they stopped him for a minimal gain.
And he'll be brought down at about the 42.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
Stevens setting up to throw it. Flush to his right. Thrown across his body and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 15. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27. The young quarterback, Charles, running to his right. I know he's right-handed, but is that one that maybe a veteran sticks in his pocket?
I think so, but you have to remember with young quarterbacks, it may take a few years before they get all the stuff out of them that they did earlier in their career or even in their college days when they were used to being dominant. In this case, the NFL veteran defense ended up winning the battle.
Coming up on a 2nd and 6. Now Fields. Over the middle and complete to Waddle.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down. Executed it to perfection. A play fake. Now Fields to throw. Eluding the pressure right. Room to run past midfield. And he gets us to the other side of midfield across the 45 before going out. The last drive, remember, similar situation. He forced a ball into coverage through the pick. He learned better there.
Yeah, similar to a golfer that's confronted with a shot that you just can't make. Sometimes you have to take your medicine, as they say, right? Just pull it down, take off, and go. Don't make something worse than what it was.
So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 44-yard line. A shotgun snap, Fields. Escaping the pressure right. Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call. So a pretty early first quarter roughing the passer penalty.
Seems like the officials are going to let everyone know they're taking charge of this game. They're always going to protect the quarterback.
So now a fresh set of downs, first and 10 after roughing the passer. Now a handoff looking right. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. Give him 5 on the carry there, and it'll be second down. Fields now to throw. Flushed out right. To the sideline. That's well done. Able to drag the feet. He's going to have the first down.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's where it really pays off. Able to move, evade, and is accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he's got him. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Rashad Bateman, his first touchdown on the year. And the Saints have taken the early lead. Point after, right down the middle. And that makes the score 7-0. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Out of the end zone comes Spencer. And that decision to bring it out ends up not being a good one. Costs him about 5 yards as he's tackled at the 20. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
Try to shake off the interception. He'll look to throw. And he's taken down here by the Saints. That one will set him back nearly 10 yards here on first down of the sack. Quite a ways here, facing second and 19. Going play action with Stevens. Looking left side, and it's complete. And he'll be out right at the 35.
But one of the ways that quarterbacks keep all the receivers alive in a play, never lock in on any one guy. Make sure you keep your eyes moving, scan the field. And here he finds the open guy for a nice pickup.
Stevens now off the play fake. They'll roll him out right. And he goes out right around the 39. He'll get five out of the scramble in second down.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir. Able to turn that into a positive game. With these run-pass options, we often talk about a good quarterback and running back. Well, having a talented wide receiver helps also.
Yeah, even coming in third in the discussion, sometimes that means he really should be first, because all you want to do is get the ball in their hands and let them make the big plays downfield.
Here's Stevens to throw. Flush to his right. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
They're bringing a lot of pressure here already in the first quarter. Already sacked him once. Now they get in there and knock another one away. You think maybe that Tucker rule being gone makes defenses a lot bolder?
Yes, indeed. That time, lucky that the arm was going forward. Incomplete pass. And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And he's going to take this across the 50 and into Saints territory. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. And for the Saints here on third down, an extra defensive back on the field. And to give this time to the tailback. And he will have first down yardage as he's brought down at the 41.
Well, that was big right there, because they're in the bottom five in the league in converting on third down. They needed that pickup in a big way.
There were two things they said they wanted to win in this game. One, the turnover battle. And the second, third down conversions. So they got one there. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll work this forward for about three at second down.
Yeah, I don't know if it's exactly a win-win, but if you're on offense, you'll take that kind of a run, all right? It was kind of stacked up, found a little bit of yardage, and frankly, they're pretty close to staying on schedule on offense. The playbook is still open for the coordinator.
Here's a handoff out of the gun. They had 3 yards on first down, just 1 yard there. But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
In search of 6 yards here on third down. This is now the ninth play of the drive. Stevens. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And he's going to be stopped here a few yards short of the first as the tackle is made at the 33. On fourth down, Stevens. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. The Cowboys here unable to convert on fourth down. And the Saints will have the football back. getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. On first down, Fields. Eluding the pressure right. That is caught, Rashad Bateman. And he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Hands it off out of the gun. And he'll work this forward for about 3 at second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play? It was only a 3-yard run, but for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
From the 36, Fields. And he'll just get rid of it.
Oh, I like that right there. Not only was it the right play, throwing it away like that, frankly, I think it was the only play.
Yeah, got outside of the pocket, realized he had nothing, just chucked it free.
Yeah, lived to fight another down, right?
Throwing on third down, Fields. Open man is Jordan, the tight end. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 14. From the gun, they'll try to run it. Try to bounce it outside, but he's only able to get it back to the line of scrimmage. Officially, no gain on the play, and it's second down. Here's Fields. Steps away to his left. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Well, we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions, and here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield, he's standing in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion. Forced out to his left. Oh, he put it on the carpet, a fumble. And he nearly got the first himself, but it appears he's going to be about a yard or two short.
Now we'll get an injury timeout here, and that is Justin Fields having some troubles down there.
Well, he gets attended to. We'll step aside. And they're going to at least line up to go for it here on fourth down. And now the first throw for the backup quarterback. Escaping the pressure right. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. The Saints' decision to go for it backfires. And the Cowboys' defense is going to get them the football back. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And last time this unit was out here, costly turnover, and then that turned into 6 points. They've got to make amends.
And how many times have we sat in meetings with coaches and they use the term complementary football? Offense take care of the defense, defense take care of the offense. That didn't happen on the last possession. This is a chance for them to pick themselves back up and help their team.
Yeah, we'll see if they can recoup and recover. The run got 4. Now they deal with a 2nd and 6. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he'll get maybe a couple before he's taken down, as that will take us
to the two-minute warning.
Call it a gain of a couple, and that's going to leave him with a third and about five. We hit halftime, as we do all season. We'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
Now Stevens.
Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down.
Normally on third down and short yardage, you're thinking to throw to your tight end. It's just going to be a simple chain mover. But this time they let him roam down the field. And a nice dart picks up the first down and then some.
Play action. Here's Stevens. Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted.
Picked off at the 38, and he'll take it across midfield and down to the 48-yard line.
Second interception for him now here in this first half. And you got to think, he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question, because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on, his teammates going to check.
And he's going to be sacked. They sack him back right at the midfield stripe. He'll wind up losing three there on the sack. Good pressure, and it's second down.
From the 50, here's Fields.
And he's got this down to the 35. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 26 seconds to go until halftime. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10.
From the gun, here's Fields.
And he's going to go down. They get to him back at the 40. The sack recorded. It's a loss of five, and now it's second down.
Another try after the first down sack. Fields.
And that will be incomplete with a clock down now to 13 seconds.
A pretty rocky start in this game for the guy throwing the ball. Already has thrown one interception. Almost threw a second one right there. All he's doing right now is giving the defense a whole lot of confidence.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw.
Got this into the hands of the tight end, Jordan.
And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys 14. Now a timeout called with 3 seconds to go. And, of course, they're in field goal range in the final seconds of this first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. And this one is right through. So it's halftime here in New Orleans with the Saints out in front. As we get you over to Orlando, where standing by is Jonathan Coachman. He has our EA Sports halftime report.
It's the Cowboys who get the football first, and they trail here as well as we resume action in the third quarter. And no run back here as the third quarter will commence with a touchback. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they trail here to begin the second half. What's going to be a key for them to get back in the game?
I think they're right there, and I think this game is still up for the taking for them because we always talk about turnovers. They had two of them in the first half, and once you start talking about if you have three, four, or five, you know it's beyond difficult to try and win a football game with that. Those have to be eliminated. If they take care of the ball, they've still got a shot.
The last run got six, now second and four. Complete. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down.
I like watching the wide receiver screen because it's a real teamwork play. Because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit. But how about the people up the block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
Officially, it's a one-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11.
I know they'd love to take some heat off of that young quarterback, but so far, not much in the running game, and this won't help things either. A loss on that play.
Second and 11 now. Looking to throw, Stevens. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10. From the gun, he'll hand this off. And he'll be brought down on the 30-yard line after a gain of six. 6 yards on that last play, here's second and four. To throw, Stevens firing quickly here, and that's complete. Oh, he's hit, he lost the football, put it on the carpet, and this is picked up by the Saints. So the turnover forced, and a wonderful job on a big return.
And how about the convoy that got created to help him get all the way back upfield? I mean, that's the part that people miss on. That's practice. That's worked on. It doesn't just happen in a game and everyone rallies. They discuss it prior to, and everyone knows their role when they create a turnover like that.
Working with second and five now. And they'll run on the inside handoff. And he'll be taken down near the 20 at the 21. They follow up the gain of five by only getting one there on second down. Here's Fields. And he's got it. Touchdown, Saints. Rashad Bateman with two touchdowns on the season, both in this game. And the Saints take advantage of field position on the turnover to cash in for six. Extra point right down the middle. And that makes our score 17-0. They will start at the 25 as Spencer elects not to return this. Set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And last time the turnover on the fumble, and they were in enemy territory, so that had to be very frustrating. Down on the scoreboard here, can't do it again.
You nailed every part of it.
Nowhere to go here. He lost the football, and this is picked up by the Saints, and they are going to take possession of the football inside the 15 at the 14-yard line.
Well, if these guys wanted to get back in this game, they needed an almost perfect second half, and down three scores, a lost fumble here certainly doesn't fit into that plan.
That reminds me of my plan in college to get an A on the papers I turned in, but that didn't work out too well either. Too many mistakes by both of us. I mean, that's just pure and simple. And that's why that's exactly where they are in this ball game. They're going to need a huge turnaround if they want to try and win this one.
It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down. On the option right is Fields. And he'll be brought down this time at the five-yard line. It's going to be a gain of six on the keeper, but it leads to a third down.
Reyes, they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football. Sustained runs, taking their time.
Oh, and a bad throw there. It's intercepted. Picked off down at the two. And he is all the way up past the 25. That's now his second interception in as many weeks from his linebacker position.
And think about all the different techniques he has to employ in a passing situation. Is he spot dropping because it's zone? Is he picking up man-to-man? Is he having to run with a running back or a tight end? In any event, great eyes, head on a swivel, and excellent hands.
Yeah, versatility and showing those hands. And he's going to be intercepted for the third time thus far. Picked off at the 48, and he's able to get it back here to the 43-yard line. Certainly not what he was hoping for, Charles. That's now three interceptions in this ballgame.
But there's a lot of knowledge to be gleaned every time you throw an interception if you do things the right way. And hasn't there been a pretty darn good quarterback along the way who threw a lot of interceptions early, learned from them, and became great later?
Who would that be?
That'd be one Peyton Manning. Threw 28 his rookie year. That's the NFL record. How things turn out for him?
I think okay. He's the guy in all the commercials now, right?
Yeah, I think he's doing okay.
Now it's Fields. And he's going to be intercepted a third time. He's picked off just shy of midfield. And they take over. They'll set up shop at the 46-yard line.
Well, still down quite a bit here, several scores, but yeah, at least that's a start, Charles, getting the interception here. And look, we're still in the third quarter, so this thing not done yet.
You're right about that, Brandon. This defense, they haven't quit on this game. They stayed with it and got an interception and handed the ball back to their offense. And what you wonder about is the team that just threw that interception, they've got to be careful about developing a sense of complacency and thinking this game is over.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. Looking to throw. Stevens. And the Saints pressure gets him. Brought down for a sack. Call it a loss of five. A big sack to bring up third down. To throw. Stevens flushed out right on the run. He'll let this go deep right side, and his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off at the 19.
Well, you just kind of feel for him right now. Four interceptions, and you can almost see through his face mask there's a lot going on in between the ears.
There certainly is, and probably way too much, because now he's probably doubting himself a little bit, wondering what adjustments he has to make. But here's what he needs to do. Get through this game. Go to the press conference. Meet it head on and show your teammates you're ready to shoulder what happened today, and you'll be ready for the next game.
And if he can do that as a rookie, that's a great sign of maturity.
Throwing on second and eight. Fields. Open net is Waddle complete. And he takes us beyond the 35 before going out of bounds.
And while we may be looking at the scoreboard, this offense certainly is not, because they're showing no signs of backing down, even with a three-score lead here in the third quarter. I think they keep taking their shots. They've seen blown leads happen throughout this league. They don't want to fall victim to it themselves.
So from the 36 now, first and 10. Here's a handoff out of the gun. And he'll grab a gain of 5 out of this up to the 41-yard line. Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
Let's go. A big play that time through the air. 30 yards. So now then, the big play has them all the way inside the 30 now, first and 10. Hands it off out of the gun. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5. Starting to become a tough spot for this defense. You're down, fourth quarter, looking a little fatigued maybe on that side of the ball.
Partner, we've seen this before, haven't we? Because every coach we've ever talked to says body language is important. And now you're seeing guys with their hands on their hips, they're bent over, hands on their knees. And the offensive guys are just saying, let's just keep running it out. We've got them now.
So from inside the 20, here's first and 10 at the 18. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And he's got him. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Rashad Bateman there to make the grab. And the Saints add on to their lead, and they are also closing in on a fifth straight victory. Extra point splits the uprights, and the lead is now 24. The kickoff team on the field now as they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. The Saints going to call the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. And let's face it, this drive is not going to have any bearing on this game, but it's kind of important for one reason, isn't it?
It certainly is. You got to get points. And okay, all right, I'm being facetious here. But you get points, you feel a little bit better about yourself as you move on to the next one.
Trying to shake off the interception from the last drive. He'll look to throw. And he's taken down here by the Saints. It'll be a loss of 10. And it'll bring up second.
It has been a rough afternoon for him trying to get rid of the football. See, that's now 5 sacks.
How'd you like to be the offensive coordinator, the offensive line coach, trying to come up with an answer for this pass rush? What blocking assignments do you change? Can guys play a little bit better? And we're seeing the end result on the scoreboard. Long day in the pot.
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off here to 29. And this one will be brought back to the 22. And you have to wonder, Charles, a game like this, 5 interceptions, what does this do to the psyche of a young quarterback?
Well, based on the fact that he's still out there and he threw a 5th interception, I'm wondering if his head coach believes that he's really strong mentally and wants him to play through it. Because otherwise, you need to get him out and fight another day, because this could leave lasting damage if he keeps throwing interceptions.
The run only got a yard. Here's 2nd and 9. To throw his Fields. Going to throw deep for the end zone. And he's got it. Touchdown, Saints. Jalen Waddle, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Saints are well on their way to a 5-0 start as they extend their lead. Point after, right down the middle. And the lead will swell by one more. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes.
of the end zone comes Spencer. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And following the interception, just any interception, are you a little bit more cautious when you start that next drive, or no, you just throw that out the window?
I think you are. I don't think that there's any way you can run back out there and go, totally didn't affect me. Let's just go ahead and be loose with the football again. You're going to take care of it, but you have to be careful about being too cautious, because now you can't run any offense at all.
Still want to attack. We'll see how they attack him here. He's going to float this over the middle deep. And he's just throwing the ball up for grabs now. Fortunately, that one's going to fall incomplete. So, Charles, you talk about this head coach and his future with this franchise. Look, it's been a frustrating year, and I think we saw some of that frustration boil over at his weekly press conference earlier in the week.
Yeah, he's trying to say all the right things, isn't he? But he's heard the rumors. He knows what's going on out there. And right now, he is tired of having to answer the question, are you on the hot seat in every meeting with reporters? This week, he kind of said, I've had enough, and I don't blame him. He looks like a guy that may very well be out the door.
To throw on third down, Stevens. And now here is another interception. Picked off near the 26. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line. Now they try the right side here. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. Second and 6.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he'll get this down only to the 18. Only a yard of the pickup there, and it'll bring up a third down. If you're going to run against this unit, especially down here, just beware. I mean, they're the top rushing defense in the league.
Yeah, and then they go ahead and they double down with the whole thing because you think, okay, let's throw the ball. Oh, yeah, that's right. They defend the pass pretty well, too. Very difficult task right now.
69 yards for him on the ground now on 18 carries.
Brandon, when a defense just simply can't get off the field on third down, and we all know how important that down is for both sides of the ball, you often feel like you're just a step behind whatever they're doing offensively.
And one of the differences in this game, no doubt, third down conversion, and that is going to be a story they'll talk about after this one. And he'll get about 4 there as he takes it from the 10 down to the 6.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
6 yards left on second down. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he will get into the end zone. It's another touchdown. This thing is ugly.
Well, business as usual for them. Well on their way to another victory. Riding a serious wave of momentum from what we've seen. And so far, they haven't met their match. So if you're going to play this team in the future, your mission is clear. You better be ready to play and match their firepower.
Extra point right down the middle. And that will extend this big lead. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. They will start at the 25 as Spencer elects not to return this. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And they've sort of lost their way, partner. How do they recalibrate and get this proverbial train back on track?
Well, this is where leadership really comes into play. How's the head coach handling it? The offensive coordinator?
And my goodness, another interception. Picked off near the 42. And the return here is stopped at the 35-yard line. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on first and 10. Now a handoff looking right. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. Second and 10. They've called his number a lot this afternoon. You wonder how much tread is left on those tires.
We certainly do, but I always think back to one of my favorite coaches in the NFL. And he used to have a meeting with his running backs every year in the offseason and say, look, as many times as you're going to carry the ball, you should be able to carry it one more time. So make sure you get in shape.
Finding room to the 20. And he's got it all the way down to the 12-yard line.
No doubt those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score.
From the gun, he'll hand this off. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals. Now the try here for the extra point. And this one was over a while ago as they just add on to their big lead. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. A solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard. So this one, a victory here for New Orleans. And I tell you what, Charles, this might be about as good as it gets. They were incredible.
Yeah, offense was in fine form. The defense threw the shutout at them. I think they worked in concert together. What I like about the offense was they held the ball pretty well. You know, time of possession, exactly what they were looking for in this one. And that helped out their defense. Didn't have to be out there the entire time. So when you do that and you're out there fresh playing, off a little extra spring in your step, and it showed up in this one.
They had a ton of spring in their step. Impressive victory.
So for the Saints, they improved to 5-0 now on the young season. And they'll get to stay home again next week as the Tampa Bay Buccaneers come to...
Religion was the moon. Made a couple million, hallelujah. Daddy was a toy. Called a homeschooler. Never did homework. I was going home with the work, no tutor. Used to have enough. Grew up with the hustlers and the killers. Now I'm kicking it with Puffy in the villa. Chilling. Click full of zombies like Thriller. Got real. About to get real. That's just how I'm feeling. Trying to make a killer, stack a couple million to the ceiling. When I touch down, I'ma.
when I touch down. I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's
them get a red eye, never make right. Me, they are suffer life, them I get by. Never bow for the fame, heads high. Never come so all them I see a tear light. Been a real from the ghetto. I ain't never gon' switch, that's facts though. Can't get me out like stain. I'ma grow tough, I'ma know a pain. Haters talk with a bad tongue. Can't break me, Tweedledee so dumb. I'ma be a giant leaf, 5-4 from doing it so big like Drake, I'm on one. My big box got me feeling so bossy like Lauren Hill, me I kill them softly. This a girl rather fi be called a naughty. Cause if my too loyal, then it's gon' cost me. And
that's just how I feel.
Yeah.
That's just how I'm feeling.
That's how I feel.
Dog, that's just how I'm feeling. I'ma burn it all to the ground. Make sure the whole world feel it. That's just how I'm feeling. Big boss, I'm a big boss. Up north, Rick Ross. I got the pump that'll make you jump. Don't you ever get it crisscrossed. Don't you ever get it crisscrossed.